Are you taking or thinking about taking a probiotic for gut health? Confused and wondering if you're going to be throwing away money or if they're overrated? With the explosion of products on the market, I get it. I'm Neely with Neely on Nutrition, providing you with unbiased, relevant health and nutrition information, empowering you to make an educated, informed decision. A past client of mine reached out asking me if I would recommend a particular a probiotic for her. I asked if there was anything wrong with her digestive system, and she's like, no, just something to help with my gut. And this was after she had already done some searching on her own, and she was really confused, quite overwhelmed with what she saw online and in the store. And with an expected 65% growth in the global probiotics market in the next 5 years, I get it. Interest in gut health, especially within the last decade, has just exploded. And along with gut health, interest in how we take care of it. And there are no loss of any recommendations for solutions or products in the gut health industry, especially related to probiotics. But what are probiotics and are they overrated? Now, this video specifically is on a probiotic for general health, and it's one of a series. So make sure that you subscribe to my channel, Neely on Nutrition, so you can get notified of my upcoming videos about gut health, probiotics, and so forth. I'll also have resources in the description below if you want to go on and do some of your own research. Why is there so much interest in gut health? Science is just really far and away very interested in what's going on in the world of our gut microbiome and how it affects our health. We all have this internal ecosystem, so to speak, in our body and on our body, and especially in the gut. I like to call them gut bugs, but I realize that you might not appreciate that word. Like, my mom doesn't like it, so we're gonna go with the word microorganisms. But there are microorganisms related to our gut. And this is all that environment is called the microbiome. Specifically, we're talking about the gut microbiome. And it evolves over our lifetime, starting at our birth. The microbiome consists of microorganisms, including bacteria, yeast, fungi, viruses, protozoa. And there's an estimated 100 trillion microorganisms in our body. Crazy, I know. Like 10 times more microorganisms than there are body cells, human cells. And we all have an individual like footprint or fingerprint. No two microbiome are the same. We're all very unique. Now, you might think that bacteria, they're bad, but actually most of the bacteria in our body is friendly bacteria. It's like this little factory just always doing good things for our body, most of the bacteria anyway. So let's talk about probiotics. What are probiotics? Well, there is no federal definition of probiotics here in the US, although there is a widely accepted scientific definition that's used worldwide. And I'll put that here on the screen for you. But to put it simply, they're live microorganisms that are mostly they're bacteria or yeast, and they're required to have research indicating that it has some kind of a health benefit that when consumed in the right amount. So it's the right organism at the right amount giving us a particular benefit. That is what a probiotic is. You can buy probiotics as a supplement, and they're also found in some fermented foods like yogurt, kefir, and kimchi. Do you need a probiotic? Well, probiotics seem to have this mythical health reputation. And I have to say, there is a lot of exciting research about the gut microbiome and its influence on our health. And there's also a lot of promising research related to how probiotics may be playing a role. However, the sales and the marketing of these probiotics far outweigh the research. I mean, the science is just not keeping up with it. And unfortunately, then, so there's a lot of things on the market that are they going to do you any good? And that's a big question. That's one of what I want to answer in today's video and in future videos. Companies that are selling these probiotics say that their products are going to supercharge our health, provide the best home for our microbiome, your gut. But will they? Well, here's the thing. This is what I want you to understand. Despite all the marketing, there is no one probiotic, no one size fits all. Let's say that you get a headache. What do you do if you get a headache? You probably take maybe an aspirin or a Tylenol. And so you think, oh, I've got a little, you know, a little bit of stuff going on with my belly. Let me just go get a probiotic. It doesn't quite work that way because all probiotics, though, they seem to be lumped into one big category, but they cannot be generalized. To give you an idea of the complexity, two of the most common classifications of bacteria are lactobacillus and bifidobacterium. And they're some of the most well-studied as well. But lactobacillus alone is composed of 170 different species underneath it. So we've got lactobacillus as the big group, and then 170 different species underneath that. And then each of those has a number of different strains associated. So we have this big group, we have a species, and like this subspecies. And each one of those does something different for the body. There's no one size fits all, unlike what the marketing would like to have you believe. Different types, different strains of probiotics are going to have different effects. Just like no two humans are alike, no two strains are alike. And every strain is different, and one strain's effect has no impact on another one. So it's really important that you find the right strain for the specific condition you need. The right strain for the specific condition you need. Now, there are some proven health benefits on some number of conditions, and I'll do that in a follow-up video. But for overall health, the research is just not there. We don't need to optimize our digestive system despite what you see on all these packages. Furthermore, a lot of the probiotics in the market are multi-strain. They may have 5 or 10 or 20 or 30 different strains in them. Sometimes I feel like the manufacturer's like, let's just throw everything in there and hope that something does its job. And you know, it's just, it's kind of crazy. It's a whole supplement world. And by the way, if you have not watched my video about dietary supplements here in the US, make sure that you watch that video. It kind of gives you a good idea of what's going on regarding supplements. And speaking of which, supplements are not required to be safe or effective. And most of the probiotics we buy here in the US are dietary supplements. So there's no proof that they even are going to do what they do or that they even have what they have in the package. So what can you do for your gut health? Well, there are a lot of things you can do. But first, just to remind you again, this is just one video of several that I'll be posting in the upcoming weeks, including like what conditions a probiotic might be good for, what specific strains might be helpful, how to read a label, because that can be really confusing. Also, what are prebiotics and symbiotics, and how to optimally take care of your gut. So yes, probiotics are overrated for a generally healthy person, and you probably don't need one. Is it gonna hurt you? Probably not, but this is what I would rather you do. We do know that the ecosystem of our gut is very complex, and things that you can change how you're eating. So, and if you're eating a more plant-based diet, which has some great fiber in it, then you're on your way to good health, good gut health. Other things that can affect your gut: stress, sleep, of course, physical activity, overuse of antibiotics. So there definitely are some things that that are important for just overall gut health. So make sure that you subscribe and watch this video and this playlist next to keep you up to date on what you need to know about this stuff. Thanks for watching Neily on Nutrition. We'll see you in the next video. Take care.